start by creating a variable called sum. This will hold the current total value. We use the state property wrapper to indicate that this variable will be managed by the SwiftUI framework and can be used to update our view. We initialize this variable with a starting value of 0. Let's add an empty Vstack container. This will contain all elements that make up our UI. Create a private variable called formatter, which is an instance of number formatter. This will allow us to format our numeric value as a currency. We set the number style property to currency, and the locale property to ENUS, so it will be displayed as a currency in US dollars. We create a Vstack container which will hold our UI elements. Within the Vstack, we create a hStack to hold our buttons. The first button will subtract 1000 from the sum variable when pressed. The second button will reset the sum variable to 0, and the third button will add 1000 to the sum variable when pressed. We are using the withAnimation method, so that the change in value will be animated with an ease and out animation, with a duration of 1 second. Let's display our current total value by using a simple text view, and pass it the value from our formatter. We set the font to be large title, and the font weight to be heavy. A good tip is to set the monospace digit property, so that the digits are evenly spaced and easy to read. Let's try to run our simulator and see what we got so far. With our basic functionality in place, let's create a new SwiftUI view file called TextAnimatableValue. This file will hold a custom view, where we will display the numeric value in a more visually striking manner. We need to make our view conform to the Animatable protocol. This allows us to use it in conjunction with animation. We create a variable called value that holds our current numeric value. By creating a default formatter, we will be able to use this view with ease. However, when necessary, a custom formatter can also be passed. We must create a computed property called Animatable Data, which is part of the Animatable protocol. This property will enable animation when the value is changed. In the getter, we return the current value, and in the setter, we set the value to the new value. Now we only need to create a text view and set its text to the value of the formatter. Now, back in the content view, let's replace the text view with our custom text animatable value view. We pass in the value and formatter as arguments. Finally, let's run our simulator and see the final result of our tutorial. Can I have a drum roll, please? You should now have the basic knowledge to animate numeric values in SwiftUI. That's it for this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful. If you like this video, please give it a like. And if you want to see more tutorials like this one, consider subscribing to this channel, it's free. And as always, leave your comments below, I'd love to hear your feedback.